Coming up on Pierce County News.
I think faith brought us together.
Tacoma Art Museum breaks ground. Layoffs expected at Pierce County Jail. And a whimsical glass bridge for sick kids. Hi, and welcome to Pierce County News. I'm Heather Radel. We're bringing you Pierce County News from the Tacoma Art Museum, a location that will soon look very different. Cowboys and Native Americans are coming together in a new way. Megan Hutton looks at how the West is transforming the Tacoma Art Museum.
Images of Native Americans, untouched landscapes, and bigger-than-life cowboys have influenced how we view the Wild West. Now the Tacoma Art Museum is leading a new charge. It will become one of the leading museums to feature Western American art, thanks to a major gift from the Haubs, a German family whose children grew up in Tacoma.
Broaden the appeal of American Western art, because it is such a wonderful part of American art history, and can teach you a lot about the history of how the Wild West was discovered, and how the painters tell the story about the frontiersmen, about the beautiful landscapes, and of course of the Native Americans.
All German-speaking people have a fascination with the West.
The rivers still run wild like the heart of a child.
A groundbreaking celebrated the Haubs' $20 million gift to build a new wing for the collection, doubling the museum's space and creating an endowment to care for it. The diverse collection includes Thomas Moran's Green River, Wyoming, and nearly 280 works from artists such as Frederick Remington, Charles Russell, and John Clymer.
It's a gift to the future, to care for the collections and for the programming, for the next generation.
We like the history, we like what we saw, but the icing on the cake was when we met Stephanie, and it turned out that Stephanie was born in Germany, spoke fluent German, and actually her hometown is the hometown of our family business in Germany. So I think fate brought us together.
Ervon and Helga Haub began collecting Western American art 30 years ago when they bought a ranch in Wyoming. They run a successful food retailer in Germany.
We would come home and visit, and we would always be looking forward to, so what is the latest, newest addition to the collection? And my father would never tell us, my parents wouldn't tell us, and they would like let us walk through the house and figure out, oh, is this a new one? Is that a new one? And that was always very exciting.
Megan Hutton, Pierce County News.
The new addition is set to open in 1 year in fall 2014. 100 to 150 works of Western art can be on display at one time. So how will this construction affect visitors, and what else is on tap for the museum this year? Joining me today is Stephanie Stevens. She is the director of the Tacoma Art Museum. Stephanie, how will this new Western art wing change the museum?
Well, Heather, first of all, we are doubling our gallery space. That means instead of four galleries at the Tacoma Art Museum, we'll now have eight. And they'll be filled with great Western American art. Works from as early as the 1820s up to contemporary times. Paintings and bronzes, for example.
Will construction over the next year affect visitors?
Well, it will affect visitors a little bit. We hope to minimize that. So for example, there'll be a moment where we will be removing our elevator. So that will be a little challenging. The front door of the museum will be moved as we add the new wing at the front section of the museum along Pacific Avenue. So you'll enter through a side door at the museum store.
What other things are on tap over the next couple of months here at the museum that we can look forward to?
Well, there are lots of good reasons to visit the museum, and again, you don't need to wear a hard hat or construction boots. At the end of the month, we are closing the Vanessa Helder watercolor show, which is absolutely spectacular. I hope people don't miss it. At that same time, we'll be opening an exhibition of the work of Jennifer Steinkamp. She does these unbelievable projections about trees, believe it or not, a tree in four seasons. And then on November 3rd, those who have a family, this is the great family event. It's our annual Day of the Dead celebration. We have some 4,000 people come. You can make sugar skulls. We have small altars. We have a big sand painting. It's a really great community day.
And what about the Polar Plaza? Because that's another event I know has been really fun. Are you hosting that again this year?
Yes, we are once again producing Franciscan Polar Plaza. The Franciscan Healthcare System is our co-sponsor on this. And we put an ice skating rink, believe it or not, across from the museum. This is an artistic ice skating rink, so there'll be bands playing, and there'll be wonderful opportunities to decorate benches and do artworks, and again, be downtown in Tacoma.
Well, sounds like there is lots to see and do here at the Tacoma Art Museum. Thanks so much for being with us today.
Great. I hope to see you and your family here.
You will. The Tacoma Art Museum is open Wednesday through Sunday, 10 a.m. until 5 p.m. The third Thursday is open until 8. The Polar Plaza Ice Rink opens November 22nd and stays open through the beginning of January. The Pierce County Jail has seen a dramatic drop in bookings now that two of their biggest contracts, the cities of Tacoma and Lakewood, are sending inmates to jails in Fife and other cities. From January to July, the Pierce County Jail saw a 45% drop in bookings. Less inmates also means less revenue from contract cities. That's why the Corrections Division of the Pierce County Sheriff's Department is facing 16 layoffs.
Our average daily population is starting to go down now. Right now we're working on closing one housing unit, which would get us down to our 1,200 inmate population cap.
In 2010, Tacoma paid the county for 6,000 bookings. That declined to 4,400 in 2012 and 980 bookings this year. Misdemeanants only staying in jail for one day also dropped from more than 55,000 in 2010 to just 11,000 this year.
We do know that we're going through some tough times right now on the correction side, and just hope we can continue working to work through it.
The Public Safety and Human Services Committee also got a report on mental health evaluations. Mentally ill inmates were waiting up to 30 days in jail for an evaluation on their competency to stand trial. A new state law allows the county to hire contract evaluators, which the state reimburses, so inmates can be evaluated within 7 days.
I believe it's going to have a huge impact on the jail if we're going to reduce the lag time of these competency evaluation for people languishing in the jail waiting for these evaluations. Is going to have a significant impact on our population.
The county reports 5 evaluations were completed in the last 2 weeks. If you have questions about which health plan will be best for you when the Affordable Care Act kicks in, a new statewide call center is ready to help. The Washington Health Plan Finder has launched a free call center to help people navigate through the process of choosing the right health care plan. Help is available in 175 languages. Starting October 1st, the Tacoma Pierce County Health Department will offer in-person, one-on-one assistance to people who have trouble using a website or call center to find out what their health care options are. Enrollment for the health plan starts October 1st, with coverage kicking in on January 1st, 2014. Pierce County Television has a new home at Bates Technical College, located on the 19th Street campus in Tacoma, along with KBTC. The partnership with Bates will bring new opportunities for media students.
Really creates a win-win, both for the county as well as for the college. You know, for us, we have the opportunity to use their studios and the systems they have there. On the other hand, it is a great and phenomenal training opportunity for students.
Work related to training is going to be the single largest determinant in your wage beyond graduation. So work-based learning experiences are really important to the student who maybe these days doesn't come with a long work history.
The Washington State Fair is in full swing, and this year there are new attractions that will wow people of all ages. We were there for opening day to check them out.
Whether it's the music, the entertainment, or the animals. For many, the opening day parade into the Washington State Fair is an annual tradition.
To see the parade, the cattle drive, and then we get in for free.
And every year, new attractions to make you smile.
Aren't you a sweet thing? You are so cute.
Like Piglet Palace, where you can enjoy some quality time with the newest litter of baby pigs. Or this year's feature attraction, Luminasia, a larger-than-life Chinese lantern exhibit specifically designed for the Washington State Fair.
And everything's handmade, so anyone who is an artist and really appreciates art for art's sake, they'll look at this and they'll say, oh my gosh, I can't believe what these guys can do with metal and fabric.
There's a traditional Chinese dragon, but also familiar landmarks like the Space Needle and Mount Rainier.
but they really, really pop at night. It's a lantern attraction. It's a luminary attraction. It's all lit. So when it's lit at night, that's when it's the most appealing. And the best part about it is it's completely family friendly.
Little fairgoers can test their tractor driving skills in this new interactive maze, or head over to the petting zoo for a close-up encounter with a baby animal.
Want to pet the sheep?
And for the big kids, the first looping roller coaster at the fair, the Rainier Rush. Of course, you still have all of the classic rides and fun.
Get your corn! Fresh hot roast corn!
And mouth-watering food that only comes around once a year.
The Washington State Fair in Puyallup runs through September 22nd. For more information, go to thefair.com. Coming up next, teen glassblowers create something special for sick kids at Mary Bridge Children's Hospital. We're back in just 60 seconds.
Listen now, can you hear the bluebirds? Oh, look up now, can you feel the sun? Oh, 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 can you feel the sun?
Take hundreds of glass balls and toss in a few octopus. Really? And what do you get? Bob Bronson says a group of teens has created a very special place of wonder and laughter to help kids heal.
It's more than 1,000 degrees inside that furnace. That's why they call this place the Hot Shop. The art of glassblowing is not for the impatient, not for those in a hurry, not for the careless.
You got a chance to get burned, you got a chance to not. Of course, if you're a glassblower, you have been burnt, though.
Foss High School student John Wright is a veteran at Tacoma's Hilltop Artists. He started the glassblowing program at 12. It was his bridge to opportunity. Life could have been a lot different.
This kept me out of trouble all these years. I mean, pretty much turned my life around off of this. That's what I wanted to do. I always liked art, but I used to always be in trouble. So this helped me start managing like my behavior too.
I always tell people it's not really about the glass. It's about the kids. The kids working as a team, being a family.
Now these students are giving back to the community that has given to them.
The production team right now is working on a glass float project for Mary Bridge Children's Hospital.
Building a bridge for children, literally. They created 1,300 whimsical floats, some of them hiding tiny sea creatures inside, to help guide young patients across the sky bridge from the main Mary Bridge Hospital to new pediatric floors.
I'm looking forward to when it's all done and over and we can go and say we helped make that.
You build a bridge piece by piece. Whether it's glass or a bridge to opportunity or relationships, it's still one piece at a time.
It's brought together two groups of children. The opportunity to design beauty for those young kids has lifted our students' hearts just in an amazing way. They see that something they make and do is of value to other young kids. They don't know yet that intrinsic inside all of us is something that's of great value no matter what hand you've been dealt. And they're learning it through this partnership. They're being esteemed by adults. They're being shown that their contribution can be a lasting thing of beauty in the community. It's an astonishing idea.
There are two floors of glass floats, awash in the colors of Puget Sound, dancing in the light. 1,300 pieces in all. The name of the installation? The Japanese word chiya. It means healing.
Our hospital is promoting health for children. Hilltop Glass Artists is promoting a healthy approach to life and work for the youth that work with them. And so for them to be able to work with us towards promoting health is a great thing.
The hope is that this healing bridge will give patients and families, 6-year-old Jaden McMenamin is one of them, a few moments of distraction.
Seven, 8, 9.
A chance for everyone who crosses this bridge to get lost for a moment.
Right there.
Get lost in the whimsy and the magic on a bridge to link young patients and young artists together.
Help.
Which is just what a bridge should do. Bob Thronson, Pierce County TV, Tacoma.
Up next, the place to go for tennis players of all abilities. But first, here are some dates for your calendar. If you'd like to learn firsthand about law enforcement in Pierce County, the Sheriff's Department's Fall Community Academy has openings. The 13-week class begins on September 26th and will meet weekly. Pre-registration is required and applicants need to be 16 or older. For more information, go to piercesheriff.org. The Fife Harvest Festival is just around the corner and there's still time to get involved. Sign up to be a vendor, join the parade, run the 5K, or just enjoy the day of free activities. The event happens on Saturday, October 5th at Daca Park. For more information, go to cityoffife.org. This week, Mark Richards has the perfect place to swing a racket.
Hi, Heather. If you need a racket this size to hit the ball, it might be time to head over to Sprinker Recreation Center for some beginner lessons. Sprinker Tennis Center offers a variety of classes and programs for all ages and abilities. If you're looking for league play or just want to sharpen up on your serve, we're ready to help you find the perfect solution. Our team of teaching professionals is here to make your first time or your next visit to our facility fun and productive. Call or go online for more information. Have you been to the theaters lately? Join the Spotlight Players for a live show of Sherlock Holmes being performed at the Meridian Habitat Center. There will be 4 performances, including one on September 28th with an ASL interpreter. Bring the whole family and support local actors. Tickets are available online. Unless you have an umbrella the size of this racket, when the weather starts to change, head on into our indoor courts. I'm Mark Richards for Pierce County News. Back to you, Heather.
Thanks, Mark. You can see Pierce County from here on PCTV. We have the original programming you can't find anywhere else. For more local focus, find your city's meeting coverage on our website anytime you want to watch at piercecountytv.org. I'm Heather Radall. Thanks for watching Pierce County News.